Hello and welcome back. Here is a query from Salvador. He writes, I was watching your video in YouTube about how to copy and paste data from one Excel worksheet to another using VBA. There's a link here to the YouTube video. I tried to do the same and copied the same coding you did, but it didn't work in my Excel. Could you please help me out? I have Excel 2011 for Mac. Here's the code I typed. Now, just have a look at the wording. I tried to do the same. Well, actually, if you look at the code that he has sent me, he didn't try to do the same. He tried to do a similar thing. Because I use in my video x comma 1, that means the data was in column A and he has the data in column J or 10. Now let's look at the complete letter. I do not get any error when checking the code on macros, but it doesn't do what it is supposed to do, so I guess there is some mistake on the loop. Looking forward for your answer and thanks in advance. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to copy this code. Okay, right up to NSUB. Control C will minimize this. And in the column 10, that is J, we will enter some data. Okay, so we'll enter A, B, car, because that's our keyword. So C, D, car, G, H, I, whatever, and we'll write car here and write T. Okay, so we have some data here in the column 10. We'll go to the developer tab, Visual Basic, and I'll insert a module. Here I will just do a control V of what I just copied, and well, I'll run this. Okay, so when I run this, you see here subscript out of range. Alright, so we need to have two sheets, all and car only. So of course that is my error, so I'm going to end this. Minimize this, go here, right click on this and rename this sheet and call it all, that is all data, and I'll add another sheet called car only. Okay, so we have the two sheets. Let's go back to the developer tab, Visual Basic, and let's run this again. Okay, so when I run this, you see there is no error. So let me minimize this. Let's go to all. So there's the data, and in car only there's nothing. Okay, but let's have a look in the area J. There's nothing. Now let me show you the code again. You see here, if cells x comma 10 is equal to car. First of all, that's a mistake. There is no such thing as car in my document. I have only a lowercase car. So that's what I'm going to do. Okay. I'm going to save this. So I'll save it now. Let's say test for car with VBA. I will go here in the save as type and select Excel macro enabled workbook. I will save it on the desktop and save. So that is saved. Now let me run this again. So you see you get an error here. Object required. Let's debug. So you see here E row is not defined. Okay, So we will go here, and below this we will write dim hero as long. Okay, we'll reset this, save this, and run it again. There's no error. So let me minimize this and have a look here. So nothing has apparently happened. Okay. What is the reason? Well, if you notice here, active sheet paste and Salvador forgot the destination part, number one, the colon. And if you notice here, he forgot to write Excel up. You see, that is why I had to define this, otherwise it would have not been necessary. You can watch here, I will write an L and I can remark this out, save this, run it again. And you see again we get an error, debug, it says object required. Okay, then we'll get this back. Frankly, you don't need this, it works without that, I know that. But here you see, he has written car only. Okay, so what you need to do is write worksheets. Because if you rename a sheet, if it's not sheet 1 and sheet 2 and sheet 3, you have to put this in this format. Okay, and we will save this now and run it again. It has run maybe, so let's have a look. All, and let's go to car only, and do we have something? Nothing. So it hasn't copied anything from this area. Although when I ran an experiment, I saw that it actually copies one of them. Okay, but now it's copying none. So let's have a look at the code again. This looks fine, this also looks fine, and there's no error, right? You see, when Salvador defines this as 10, the column 10, and here we are counting the hero from the cell 1. Okay, so this is a major problem. So I'm just going to make this 10 and let us see what happens. Okay, so I made this 10. I will save this. Now I'm going to close this. I'm going to close this also. Then I'm going to reopen that file, arrange it back to the size of the video. Enable the content. We'll go to our developer tab, Visual Basic, and let's run this now. So you see something happened now. Did you notice that? If you had seen this here, you would have seen it said running. Okay, so let me minimize this. And here is our data. Here is car only. And let's see. You see 1, 2, 3, and 4. So 4 cars have been copied from all. Let's have a look whether there are 4 or 5. I didn't know that. So 1. Press the control key, 2, 3, and 4, and you can see also it has selected. Okay, so the important thing is that if you are doing such a thing, copying from one column and then you're copying the rows, you see every time the code copies the row and is counting from 1, okay, it sees the starting point as blank and therefore it keeps on overwriting. In fact, in this case it wasn't even doing that, so you didn't see even one copied car. Okay, so now how can you for example, confirm that this is because of the 10. So I'm going to remove it. And here, we will copy to the cell. We will say, copy this to the cells E row, comma 1 in the sheet car only. So we are going to copy from all and paste it into car only at this point, that is in the E row and column 1. So before I do that, let me minimize this, go to my worksheet, go to car only and delete this. Okay. And let me write some heading here. Let's say data extracted. You need not go to this sheet, but let's do that as a matter of abundant precaution. And now I'm going to run this again. So I'll go to the developer tab, Visual Basic, and run this code. And let's see what happens. Okay. So there you saw running. Let's minimize this. And it has come right up to here. We'll go to car only. And you see still it hasn't come here. Only one data has come here. Because we are copying the rows, so it appears that we need to adopt a different strategy if we want to paste the data here. You see, we are pasting a cell and here we have rows. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to change this to cells X, 10. That is the cell that will be highlighted if it has the keyword car. We will copy that cell and paste it into our cell E row, 1. Now let's run this, minimize this, and let's have a look at car only. And you see 1, 2, 3, and 4 from all 1, 2, 3, and 4 have been extracted. So this is the solution to Salvador's problem. If you make drastic changes to your data and to your VBA code, then you must be careful. Otherwise, you can just say, I did the same thing. Well, did you notice it wasn't really the same thing, isn't it? I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.